everyone. Welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are doing well today, and I welcome you if you're new here. I'm Lexi Laurie, and in today's video, I'm going to be telling you guys about my horrific period experience over the past decade of my life. I'm going to be telling you, how it started, how I transitioned into, different forms of care for my period, and how where I'm at now with natural feminine care and all that different stuff. I feel like I've hit a place in my life where this is something that I'm only just now, I feel like, getting a hold of and really starting to actually not mind when my period comes on. Like, there was a time when I feel like I hated it. Like, I would be dreading the next time it would come on. And now I'm at a point in my life where it's like, you know what? If it comes on, it comes on. Like, I'm not gonna be upset about it because I know the reason why we get periods is because he's cleansing himself out of the egg that didn't get fertilized. And if you want to have a kid someday, that's actually a good sign if you're, getting a period every so often or regularly, whatever your cycle is. So I'm going to be going into all that today, just sharing my story about my painful periods and what helped and where I am today. I hope you guys enjoy this video, and let's just hop right into it without further ado. All right, so I want to first off by just giving you guys a little bit of background about my period and how it started, when it started, just the consistency of it back then. So basically, I got my period a month before my 11th birthday, and I'm a summer baby, so I wasn't in school when I got it, thankfully. I feel like that would have made it, for me, a lot worse if I got it while I was in school and it just got everywhere and stuff like that. So thankfully I got it during the summertime and I was almost 11, so I guess I could say 10, but I was literally 4 weeks away from being 11, so I don't know, call that whatever y'all want, 10 and a half, I don't anyway. So when I first got it, first of all, y'all, I didn't even know, like I knew about periods because I grew up around women, and my mom's a woman, I have sisters, so I'm used to being around that kind of thing, but it just wasn't talked about in my household. You got your period, you handled it, and you didn't say anything about it. Even with my grandparents and older generations, nobody talked about it. Nobody talked about it with me. Nobody told me what to do when it came. So I was kind of a little clueless. I did have cousins who got it before me, and they would be like, oh my God, I got my period, kind of thing. And, they'd be like, oh, get you a pad. Come on, cover that up. Do what you gotta do. Hush, hush about it. So that was pretty much my only knowledge that I had about it when I first got my period. Yeah, I think I got it one day when I was go to the bathroom, and I was just I saw blood. So I was oh my gosh, I haven't been drinking enough water, I'm gonna die, I don't even know where that came from, y'all. I don't know where I read that at. Probably nowhere, because that's not even true. But in my head, I'm thinking oh my gosh, I'm bleeding because something's wrong, I haven't been drinking enough water or something. And I even told my mom that. I was like, mom, I haven't been drinking water, I'm gonna die soon, I'm gonna miss you. My mom's looking at me what is wrong with you? So that's how my period started. And of course, when it started, I wore pads. For the first couple months that I had it, I wore tissue because I was scared to tell my mom why I was saying those things about me about to die and stuff like that. First of all, she didn't even ask questions. She just looked at me okay, go on, bye. Not like that, but in a way, she just thought I was kind of being funny, I guess. I did have a tissue thing going on for a couple months, and then I finally told my mom, and then I just started using the pads that she had, honestly. So that's a little fun background story of how my period started and pretty much what I did when it first started, which I transitioned from tissue and underwear to pads. And then of course, eventually I'm gonna get into the rest of the story, but I started wearing tampons when I was about 15 years old. Definitely not faithfully, definitely not often either, because number one, it hurt a lot, because I was definitely not putting them in right. And also, I just feel like, I don't know, it just were not the most comfortable for me, especially back then. But I was a dancer, I was a cheerleader, I did so many different things, so I kind of had to at least see what that tampon world's about, because nobody likes having accidents while you're at a football game or while you're at a dance recital or something like that. That is a big no-no. So we was like, I was like, gotta get that together. On and off throughout high school, I would wear them, but only on certain days. I would only wear them if I had a recital or a game on the day where I was bleeding a little bit heavy, kind of thing. And I also forgot to mention that I do, and I feel like I've pretty much always had kind of heavier periods. Now, when I first got my period, it was regular, I guess. It came on almost every month. I really wasn't tracking it, so I didn't know. But it came on often, but it wasn't heavy as it is now. So over the years, it kind of got progressively heavier and worse over time. So that first couple years, I guess, it wasn't nothing crazy, but it still was okay, that's a flow. I remember just sitting down in my room one day. I had got a period, and I was just yo, I'm in so much pain right now, y'all. that's all I kept thinking. Like, I'm in so much pain. I don't want to go anywhere. I don't want to go to school. I don't want to do anything. And I just remember feeling like, why do I have to feel like this? Like, why does it have to be this way? So what I resorted to do, which a lot of people do, I know, is take medicine. Like, I took so much medication, y'all. Like, I would even, if I thought I was gonna get a cramp, before the cramp even came, y'all, I was popping some Tylenol, some Advil, some Midol, some Pamprin, like all of that. I was popping all of those, you guys. And I did that literally from like almost 15 ish around that time before I started wearing tampons to recently, I would say about a year ago, when I started to really find other ways to alleviate the cramps, the terrible cramping, without always having to take medication every single period. And I can honestly say that now today I do not have to take pills every single period, and I'm so thankful to God for that. I mean, I'll kind of get into a little bit why I kind of wanted to get off those, you know, pills in a way, like not be popping pills like 12. Literally, I was popping so much medication, y'all, just trying to get it to stop. So let's say I'm about 60 at this point. I'm wearing the tampons every so often. I have painful periods. It's making me not want to go to school, not want to go to dance classes, not want to go to cheer practices, nothing, not even musical. I was on so much stuff, y'all. I didn't want to do anything when that time of the month came around. Like, I was just like, I just want to stay in this bed and wallow away. To my mom, like, I would always just say, oh, like, I'm up here, like, it just hurts just a little bit, so I kind of want to stay home. And no, she didn't let me stay home because she wanted me to get my education, which was fine. But I just remember being in so much pain, like walking around school, like, why am I here? Like, I'm like this is like the worst thing ever. And also another note, I didn't even get it checked out or go to a GYN until I was 19 years old. So I dealt with this for like 4 years. It wasn't fun. Definitely was not fun. So how I coped by medicine. I coped by heating pads. I coped by hot showers, all that different stuff that people do to cope with their cramps. But my main reason why decided around that time when I went to GYN for the first time that I did not want to continue to take medicine, because another thing they did offer me when I first went was to get on birth control, because they said it would regulate the periods, will make it less heavy, and, you know, make the cramps a little bit less too. And I know there's also a condition that I put it right here where it literally just gives you painful periods, and my doctor has never confirmed that, or she's never, like, you know, said, oh, you need to take medication for this condition, but she did say that you kind of have like a high likelihood that you have that. But it's nothing that could affect my fertility or anything, so thank God for that. The turning point for me when I felt like, all right, like, enough is enough. Like, first of all, I was taking so much medication that the medication stopped working for me. Like, it just, like, nothing was working. And I kind of didn't want to get on birth control because of all the terrible things I had heard from, like, other family members and older women that I had in my life. So that was, like, also a no-no for me. So I had to figure out a way. How am I going to get rid of these cramps? Like, y'all, like, that's all I kept thinking about. How am I going to get rid of these? So after a while, I started to look online and see what is there. Like, what is something I can do to get over this, because this is something that I was going through like daily, like that 5 to 7, you know, ish days, mostly 5, that I would be going through that, and it would be happening for at least 3 out of those days. I needed a remedy. I couldn't stop going to school. I couldn't stop, you know, going to work if I was working at the time. So what I have began to do, and what has really helped me, is number one, learning my body, of course, so that I know. So like, for me, I cannot be taking medication like just to prevent it if it hasn't happened yet, because that's not even good for your body, first of all. And me learning that was definitely so huge. So I stopped taking all those pills. I stopped taking like 12 pills a day. And what I started really doing that helped me out the most, and y'all probably gonna think this is so weird, but it was literally drinking hot beverages, like hot tea, and not scalding, burn your esophagus kind of tea, but just like a warm sensation drink. That was the most beneficial thing to me, you guys. And that's something that I still do even till this day. I'll put some down in the description box, some of my favorite teas. I love Yogi. I love Sleepy Time Tea. Those are my top two. Any other ones, I'm kind of just like rotating between kind of thing. So yeah, those herbs and that tea, y'all, it really helps out so much. Like, I don't know what is in it that makes it not hurt as bad, but y'all, going from taking a million pills a day to literally doing something more natural, like drinking tea and even taking a hot shower, like I've mentioned in a video before, like that, those are the two things that have helped me out so much and made me be able to cope. All right, so now I want to get into the other part of my story, which was my whole switching to more like a natural feminine period care routine, I guess, in a way. So basically, like I told you, I started off wearing pads, and I transitioned to pads and tampons, and then I slowly just transitioned to just tampons, and then now it's like a mixture of pads and tampons. But when I started wearing those, I was wearing the most unnatural stuff, y'all. When you do research and find out how bad that stuff is for you, you're just like, why am I putting this in my body? And it's going in there. So like, and it has all those dyes and chlorine and all this properties on it, radons and all this stuff. And when I started looking into that and discovering that stuff, y'all, I was like, there's no way I was putting this inside of me anymore from this day forward. I know there's so many different options. They have like organic tampons and pads. They have the menstrual cup, which is something I definitely want to try. And if I do try it out, y'all, I'm gonna take y'all with me on that journey, because I ain't gonna lie, I'm kind of nervous about it. So maybe one day we'll get there. But they also have something called like a ring kind of thing, but they're not like, I don't know, like they're weird, like they're hard to explain, but they have this like ring basically that you put up there and it absorbs. They have sponges you can use. That sounds a little unsanitary to me. But we are still discovering this whole world of natural feminine care, because women, we have this monthly. Some people, not even monthly, some people just have it a few times a year even, but it's still something that all of us have to go through. So what I found that works the best for me is just going with a more natural form of tampons and pads. And for me, I actually have some of them here with me today. This is the brand of pads I use, y'all. Like, I literally switched to these probably like middle of last year. I go between these, and they have a L brand, it's called. I'll put those on the screen right here. I found them at Target, so they're not really hard to find. But yeah, so these pretty much are just chlorine free pads. I know they have one by Rayel as well, and those also are really good, and I've tried those out. I just got these because people was buying up stuff at Target, y'all, because of the quarantine. Okay, so I got these, and I know they worked good before, so I wasn't too concerned. So I got these in regular, just for one of those days where it's not as bad. Or I'll just wear it with, you know, a tampon or whatever. So they're absorbent, they do good. I mean, no, they're not the ones with all those chemicals in it, but I feel like they personally, that they still do a really good job, and I would definitely recommend them. These are the ones by Seventh Generation. If you have a Target or anything nearby you that sells these, I would highly suggest to check them out and really start to, if you're someone who doesn't want to wear a menstrual cup or a ring or a sponge, because I'm not there yet, but maybe I will get there someday and I will let you guys know. But if you're not on that level, I would at least say to start to invest in organic period care, because, or menstruation care. And I only say that because, y'all, like, it's a growing process, and as you know and learn more, you do better. Like, when you know better, you do better, kind of thing. And when I learned of all the harmful and strange chemicals that are in these pads, not these ones, but the regular ones, like Always, Kotex, and all those brands like that, when I learned what was in that stuff, y'all, I had to make a change. So that's what I've been doing. And I honestly, I don't want to say this is associated with that, but I'm not even going to lie, you guys, like, my period cramps have been, I'm not gonna say gone since I've started using more natural stuff. No, they're not gone, but they have a little bit slightly decreased, and I don't get them as bad as before. Now, I personally don't know if it's because of switching to the natural menstruation care, the organic care stuff. I don't know if it's because of that, or if it's because my body's going through a change. Like, I don't know. But whatever it is, I'm just saying that it's worth looking into, y'all, because this has been the most life-changing thing for my cycles. Now, I also have these, y'all. These are the Honest Organic Cotton Tampons. And I honestly feel like even though they're more natural, they don't have all those harmful chemicals in them or nothing like that. And it also says they have a plant-derived compact applicator. So it still makes it easy, as if you were using like a Playtex or a Tampax or Kotex or any of those other brands of tampons. This is what they look like, y'all. They come in this little small package. And of course, you got to pull it out and then expand it and do all you got to do to get it in there. But yeah, so those have been the two things. These are the brands that I typically go to the most. Now, I have used other natural ones, which I have, but they're like nearly empty, so there's no need to bring those out. But these have been my two go-tos for tampons and pads, y'all, like some of the goats, y'all. And now we're here today, and that's honestly how I cope with them. I literally was just on my cycle a day or two ago, so I was just using all those things. And I always like to have extra stuff too, so that's why this one is not open, because I had an extra one just in case. I don't ever want to be stranded somewhere and not have that period carry on, because that's a stressor I just don't want to have, y'all, okay? Last but not least, I just want to talk about kind of why and my whole thing behind really getting away from stuff that's so non-organic and that's so harmful and all these different chemicals and stuff, like even in the medications I was taking that were so unnecessary. Why I got away from that is because I'm really just thinking about my future, and Lord's willing, I have a future, in fertility, and I don't want any of that stuff to, I guess, like, affect me negatively. Like, I was thinking about me taking all those pills really does kind of hamper me in a way, because I'm someone who someday I would like to have a natural birth when I have kids. So I feel like if I'm over here taking 12 or 15 pills a day and, you know, trying to not feel this, trying to not feel that, it's like I'm not even giving my body a chance to do what it naturally, you know, needs to do to cleanse out, kind of thing, and just use like more natural ways to kind of subside the cramps. I'm literally trying to get rid of them completely, like, and I don't think that that's personally a good idea. And even when the doctors were suggesting, like, oh, get on this pill, get on this shot, get on this, and they're like, yeah, and you won't have a period for 3 months. And it's like, well, that's not what I want for my life, you know? So if you're someone who's like me, I would definitely say to do your research. Please do your research, see what works best for your body. And if you are someone who needs to get on a birth control to lighten your periods and lighten the cramps, and do what you gotta do. Like, don't listen to a girl on YouTube who something's working for her. Maybe it might not be working for you. Like I said, everybody's different. So please do your research. Make sure you are using stuff that is the best for your body type and your menstruation needs, that is. I'm thankful that I'm, you know, slowly transitioning to more natural ways of life to hopefully, Lord's willing, have healthy childbearing years whenever that time does come in the future. And to be able to just honestly educate, hopefully if I have daughters at some point in life, if God gives me that, I'll be able to educate them on how to take care of themselves, and really so that they don't have to go through what I went through when I was a kid, when I felt like I couldn't talk to anybody, when I felt like I had to wear tissue and stuff like that, y'all. I've come a long way on this period journey, and no, it's not easy, and every cycle can come with its ups and its downs, especially mentally with these hormones, y'all. Definitely, learn your body, learn your cycle, and really just do what you have to do just to make sure you are healthy, number one, and doing what's best for you. So yeah, guys, that is all I have for this video. I just thought it would be kind of fun to share my period story in a way, and share just my journey through the different phases and what I've worn before to take care of my period and what I'm doing now, and to hopefully encourage you girls out there to just really you know, look into stuff, go to your doctor if you need to, do what you have to do just to make sure that you are coping in a way with this blessing that God has given us. Don't be ashamed of that, y'all. Don't be ashamed to get help. Don't be ashamed to look into these other methods, y'all, and just educate yourself on what is happening with this body that God has given you, y'all. When you know better, you can do better. And that's what I always say, y'all. I hope you all enjoyed this video. Like I always say, comment down below any of your period stories. Maybe share if you've had painful periods, or if you are someone who has those light 3-day periods. So share that down below just so women can see that we are all so different. Like, I love y'all, and I'll talk to you in my next video. Bye.